Hi guys, we're Yulia and Peppy from Wormy Collective, and today we'll be showing you guys how to build these very cute love messengers. So when I press the button on my love messenger, both of ours light up, and the same happens when Yulia presses the button on her love messenger. And this works no matter how far apart we are in the world.
This is super cool for loved ones, friends, or if you're in a long distance relationship. They're very simple and cheap to make. As you can see, we also love the handmade look of them.
In order to understand how the communication between the microcontrollers and these love messengers work, you can refer to one of our previous videos that's linked up here. And without further ado, let's get building! The materials needed to make two love messengers include, first, some translucent filament for the heart, some filament of your choice for the casing, two ESP32 microcontrollers, two Adafruit illuminated push buttons, some wires, some heat shrink tubes, two RGB LEDs, two micro USB wires that are used to power and transmit data, 8 M2 screws that are 10mm long, and 6 220 ohm resistors.
The equipment you will be needing for this project is a 3D printer. We're using a bamboo printer. You will be needing pliers, wire strippers, some small screwdrivers, a solder sucker, a soldering kit, and a heat gun, but we'll be using a rework station instead. Both works equally well.
The materials are all linked below and are also in our GitHub repository. Next, we shall move on to the process of building the love messengers. We recommend that you start by 3D printing. Download all four 3D models from our GitHub repository. There are two models for the heart and two parts for the box and casing. We use the translucent filaments for the hearts. Since we have a bamboo P1S printer, we slice them in Bamboo Studio. We then printed them with supports. The two heart halves took about 1 hour 20 minutes to print and required 30 grams of filament. Then we continued with the box and casing. I wanted mine to be green and Yulia wanted hers to be black. Again, we printed them with supports. The two boxes took around 2 hours of print time and 48 grams of filament. When all the prints are done, carefully take out all the supports from the 3D prints. The encasing box has a hole where the heart sits in. The heart should fit firmly, but feel free to add a little bit of glue to make the connection super stable. The front hole is where the button will sit. Now, let's get started with setting up Firebase. In order to create a project, you must be logged in to your Google account. We shall first set up an account and a project. Head over to Firebase. Click Get Started and create a project. Give a name to your project. Disable Google Analytics and now wait for it to load. Press Continue and now we're in the project console page. Now let's set our authentication method. On the left panel bar, select Build and then Authentication. Click Get Started. Select Anonymous. Toggle Enable and then save. Let's now create the database. Head over to the left panel bar again. Select Build and then Real-Time Database. Select Create Database. Enter your location. In the security rules, select Start in Test Mode. You have now created your real-time database. Now the important part, copy and save the database URL into your notes. We will need it later in the ESP32 code. Now, let's get our API key. Near the top left corner, click on the little gear and select Project Settings. This is another important thing to note. Copy and paste the web API key. We would also need this in our code. Before assembling the love messengers, we want to upload the code onto the ESP32s. Install your favorite version of Arduino. In this case, we're using Arduino 1.8.19. Go to Arduino, Preferences, and in the Additional Boards Manager URLs, paste this link. The link can also be found in the description below.
Then close the windows, go to Tools, Board, Board Manager. Search for the ESP32 in the Boards Manager window. Install the ESP32 library by ESPRESSIF Systems. Then close the Board Manager window. Go to Sketch, Include Library, Manage Libraries. In the tab, search for Firebase ESP Client, and then install the Firebase Arduino Client Library for ESP8266 and ESP32.
Next up, search for Wi-Fi and download the Wi-Fi built-in by Arduino library. Plug your ESP32 into your computer. Go to Tools, Board, ESP32 Arduino, and then select ESP32 Dev Module. Then go to Tools, Port, and select the new port that just opened. Now, download the code from our GitHub page. The code for each ESP32 is different. For the first ESP32 microcontroller, download the code user1 from our GitHub page. In the code, change the Wi-Fi SSID and Wi-Fi password into your own Wi-Fi name and password. Also add your API key that you retrieved from Firebase in the previous step, as well as the database URL. We decided to allow the RGB LED to shine a random color out of these 5 color options every time they light up. You can modify the color codes to whatever best suits your needs. Now upload your code. If you see red, don't panic, it's just uploading. Be patient. And once you see 100%, it should be fully uploaded. Disconnect this first ESP32 that you just used. Connect the second ESP32 to your computer and download the code user2 from our GitHub page. Do the same for this ESP32. Change the Wi-Fi SSID, password, API key, database URL, and finally upload your code again. Note that in our code, we commented out all the print lines so that the communication between the ESP32s and the real-time database could be as fast as possible. However, if you wish to test things out, feel free to uncomment any of the print statements.
Next, moving on to the assembly. First things first, you will need to remove all legs from the ESP32. We found it easiest if you use pliers to cut all of them apart into single legs, and then use a soldering iron to remove each one individually. Lastly, it helps to use a solder sucker to remove all the remaining solder. Then let's assemble the RGB LED. The RGB LED has 4 legs. One leg is used to control the redness of the LED. The next one is ground. This leg is the longest. And next we have the green leg, and lastly the blue leg. Trim down the red, green, and blue leg and solder a 220 ohm resistor to each of them. Then connect the other ends of the 3 resistors, as well as the ground pin, to wires. Take out your heat shrinks. Cut them to length so that all 4 of the exposed metal pins are covered. Shrink the tubes by applying heat.
Now for the button. The button has 4 legs. 2 of these are for the LED that's inside the button. These 2 pins are indicated by a small plus and minus. The other 2 detect whether or not the button has been pressed. Follow this wiring diagram to wire your button up. We want to connect the wire for the LED ground to the button detection ground. However, before doing that, make sure you include the heat shrink wraps. The last step is to connect the button and the LED to the ESP32. Refer to this wiring diagram. The blue pin is then soldered to pin 14 of the ESP32. The green pin is soldered to pin 12. Finally, the red pin is connected to pin 13, and the ground is obviously connected to ground. Before soldering the button, make sure to install the LED first, then the button into the box and casing. The positive wire of the button goes to pin 26, and the button detection pin goes to pin 27 of the ESP32. Once again, the ground pin goes to ground on the ESP32.
Now let's get to the final assembly. Place the ESP32 inside the box encasing. Then screw the bottom piece on the underside of the encasing.
Now, do the same for the other Love Messenger.
And now connect it to the power supply. Ta-da!
This is a final demo of the Love Messengers. So when I press the button on my Love Messenger, both of ours light up. Same thing happens when Yulia presses the button on her Love Messenger. Yay! And you can also see the Firebase working in real time as well.
We hope you had as much fun building this project as we had building our little love bots. Let us know if you have any questions or suggestions in the comments. And for sure, let us know if you've successfully built our first open source project.
And that's it, guys. See you guys in the next video. Yay!
And for anyone wondering why Peppy was suddenly so tall, beep, beep, beep.